money for them.
All right, where do we want to go?
Let's go to the drift school.
All right.
Say that insane to give it a prime, bro.
Dads, what's going on?
I'm just chilling, bro.
Hell yeah.
Can I do my thing, you know? Sure. What's up with you, man?
Hell yeah.
You said you wanted to talk about something?
Fuck all, aye. Oh, yeah. I had an idea.
What's
okay?
Your idea?
I thought about it the other day. So, it does involve the drift school, actually. So, we do have some people that work there. There's a couple of people that still do shit, which is fine. This won't affect what they do. They can still have fun and fucking keep making me money because selling drift kits still does make a fair bit of money, which is good. But I was thinking, like Mona and shit and everyone else, they're cooking meth, right? They're out there doing that sort of stuff.
Correct.
And they're always fucking, I feel like when I was doing it, they were always struggling to find spots like hide out and fucking cook and shit like that, you know what I mean? In a bit more safety.
Hmm.
What if we set up some sort of like, maybe not give it access to everybody, but people that we kind of trust a little bit more, or maybe everybody. I don't fucking know.
Full members.
But charge
full
a
members.
Fee. Oh yeah. No, I mean expand this to other gangs.
Yes, you're using your brain. Goods.
So expand this to other gangs, and allow them access to the area that we have in a bit more of a safe manner, because this is out of the way. They can use this spot to fucking have meetings. They can use this shit to fucking put up a meth table in a fucking container or some shit up on top of that fucking thing up there. I don't know.
I think you're... Listen.
What, they gotta give us money, materials, some shit. I don't know.
Exactly. And you only offer this to groups that can be controlled. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, 100%.
Come here. You see? This is a brilliant idea. Shano. Listen, I was thinking about going crazy because I said that we should fucking sell goddamn drugs and everything out of the storage in there. I was like, fuck it. It's dead. I'll be honest with you, man. I don't mean that in a bad way. It's just, I know how much this business has struggled because it's very, I think the word I used was seasonal. You know what I mean? It's like,
oh, 100%. It really is.
I'm very sure that there are some weeks when drifting is the thing that you just have too much business and too many people want to learn. And I honestly.
Without it, and you can't get anyone down here.
I'm not kidding, bro. If you can make this happen, you just need to fire the right people. You have to fire people
I'll fucking remove
exactly
everybody right now, pretty much. There's a couple of people, honestly, what? What?
I knew you'd be on board with this. Yes.
Oh shit! I thought you were angry that I said I want to keep.
No. It's good.
Yeah. Because I still want.
Suddenly, chat. Oh wow. Boost,
you know, drifting. So they're like, oh, the drift school's still a thing. Whatever. Oh, drive past people are drifting. It's a drift school. Then they just keep driving. That's it. That's all we need. We need the tiniest cover. The couple of drift cars here and there. Couple of tweets here and there from people that actually work here and clock in, but that's it. We don't need anyone else. Are you hiring? Yeah, maybe. Give us your number and we'll call you back. Never call them. Fuck them.
Chat. I didn't even.
We've got storage here.
I didn't even DM him.
I will say this though. I am still putting in a proposal for asset free garage because I still need to keep the cars here and that'll help me out anyway. But we got another car park there too. We got the boat, bro. The whole boat is attached to the school. The office, you can change clothes, everything.
Okay, he's going off script here a little bit. What the fuck? Wait, what do you say about the boats? What?
Well, we've got the boat. You can just climb up on the boat, you know what I mean? We can't really do anything with it. Like, you can't go into the containers and shit, but...
Are you sure you're not overcooking here?
Wait, what do you mean? Oh, if you wanted to fucking go cook...
Fucking with you. I think it's a great idea. Listen, Shano. The thing about here, you know, come here, it's way too loud. The music's way too fucking loud. Oh. I'm going to tell you right now, bro, the biggest issue with a drift school is that it doesn't have that extra oomph. You know what I'm saying?
Because when the drifting is out of season, suddenly it's just an empty space.
Yeah, I agree.
I think this should be a fucking goddamn shootout zone. Straight up, no cap. I'm telling you right now, bro. People get up, fucking go-karts, start snapping shots at each other and shit, bro. Modern day duels and shit. I don't give a fuck. We need to do some crazy shit.
Hey, you imagine if you... Well, let's just say we're at war with someone, right? We're at war with Rust or whatever. Who gives a fuck? We're at this gate. They're at the other gate. Someone's on the fucking speaker up there. 3, 2, 1. The gate's open. And then boom.
That's what I'm saying. Goddamn gladiator. Everyone, shit. This is the arena.
Full gladiator.
Bro,
yep.
I'm telling you.
You want to settle it for once and one last time, but instead of on the street?
Now you're thinking. Now we're snapping heads right here. Let me turn that off. Oh, you can turn it off, right? I think that's a perfect idea. Listen, Shano. And you know what? And that, you know why I like your idea? Because you just need to choose the right people who actually won't fucking snitch. And
yeah,
there's that degree of separation, right? Oh, yeah, they're just a client who does drifting once in a while.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we just give him like literally just track staff or some shit, like easy. Like, no one's going to look at that. Not a fucking chance.
Exactly. That's what I'm fucking saying. Chano, you're thinking. My God. Good. Oh, my God. He's actually thinking, Chad.
You planted the seed a while ago, okay? When I said, I got a bit of money, and you said, you got to fucking use it for something. You got to do something with it. I planted the seed.
I'm not even kidding, Shano. The money that you have, brother, is way too much. Like, it's you have too much. You're worrying about nothing. I get nervous. I don't want you to be somebody, Shano.
Something's going to come up.
No. You're going about it the wrong way. You have the business. If there is an opportunity for growth, people will give their money to support you. And I'll be honest with you, Shano. Maybe things would have been a bit better if you had other people invested. I'm not saying... I mean, like, as a Seaside member, I'm happy that you did what you did, of course, because now you have complete power and you answer to no one, right? But in terms of the business popping off, like, you know, I always imagine if you did this in tandem with other people, it might have been a little bit more, you know, pop off a little bit more for your sake. But
well, remember our original conversation?
Yeah, exactly. I do.
Like, OOC, like,
I remember.
Bro, I reached out to everybody, man. I had CG, fucking some of those guys were involved, like fucking Mr. K was going to get involved. Snow was going to invest in here. And then just fucking all just fell through. And then we ended up needing to buy cars and shit. And we just fucking, I borrowed the money off someone. Or off fucking James Hayes.
Well, there you go. I tried.
It's just one of those things, you know?
Let's think about the logistics again tomorrow. Like, let's do it properly. Tell me what you have planned. Yeah. I'll give you suggestions on which gang should be approached. I think people
that's what I would need. I would need that 100%. Who's not going to fuck us around?
Exactly.
People could really fuck us or fuck me around, but...
Exactly. People...
If we choose the right people, then we're good. If we put it to them, like... The thing is, I need aluminium to run this place, right, with the drift kits. Boom. You want access to here? Bring me fucking 10,000. Oh, maybe that's a bit too much. Well, it's only like 70K.
That should be okay. I don't think that'd be a problem at all. I think that's like, fucking light.
If they've got fucking free range down here, obviously be smart about it, but, you know, use this for whatever you want. For like 50K a week, fucking... Doesn't sound bad to me at all.
Listen, I got a perfect batch of first customers, man. We can talk to the Vagos.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was one. Yeah, because they're obviously right there.
They're right there, and they're not wilding out too much right now. You know, they can still be controlled because they're not...
They stick to their fucking...
the gangs that are rebuilding will play it a little bit safer, and that's the kind of gang that we need to approach. Maybe them, maybe Rust, you know, depending on the situation. I think that would be a brilliant idea. I think that's good. That's great, Shano, honestly. And I'm telling you right now, bro, when it comes to your money, don't be too, like, whatever you might have to pay for, don't be too hung up on that, all right? Like, I think like half of what you have probably make you feel a lot better than having nothing at all. Just, I want you to be loose with the money so you can enjoy your fucking hard-earned money, bro. You know what I mean? Like you made it.
Not, I think it's about time.
Yeah, Shano, listen, not many people can say they've done what you've done. You know, like you got two successful businesses. One definitely popping off because Hayes is looking like crazy every other day now. Overboost, you know, it has its ups and downs, but I think it's time for you to just go full crackhead with it, you know? And you got us supporting you, so it's the best time. You're no longer, you're not gangless, you know, Shano?
Hey, fucking, I know that for sure.
There you go. I'm glad, bro. This is huge, man. Bro, this is huge. Chat, you don't understand. This is actually fucking huge, bro.
You need to find the right people, pitch it in the right way, it will be fucking sweet.
Exactly. All right.
Bro, you could do drops here and everything. Drops over there, pick it up by...
That's what I'm saying, bro. We just need to start floating the ideas properly. You know what I mean? Like, you know the other day, you know what made me think about that? I was actually in the water after committing a crime, and I swam all the way here and just hid inside the office. And I was just like,
well, that's what I mean.
I was like, this
imagine
is such
if this
an...
was ended up being a getaway spot.
Yeah, I was
bro,
like...
You, imagine if we needed to get away, park a car in the car park, swim, jump in it, pull it out the gate, boom.
So I mean, you're doing dodo 5 minutes away, you know, done.
Yeah, exactly. Boom, jump in a dodo truck, you're fucking out.
Fucking.
Yeah, there's plenty of options.
Yeah, I'm going to make sure I expand on that tomorrow. Good shit, Shano. I'm going to leave you with Michael, okay?
What did you want to talk to me about? Anything?
Hey, no, you just talked about all of it.
Along the lines of that.
That's literally what I was going to talk about, man. What the fuck?
Oh, fuck. Okay.
So, thanks, bro. Appreciate you, Shano.
Yeah, all good then. All good.
Hold it down.
Right, see you, mate. Yeah,
yeah. Let me call Reggie, bro, and rub it into his fucking face. Fucking Reggie, bro. Omi, what's up?
Yeah, give a sec. What's up?
Who are you talking to?
Who am I talking to?
Yeah.
Isa.
Are you serious, Michael?
No, I'm not serious.
Jesus fucking, who are you talking to?
I'm talking to Benji.
No, who are you talking to, Michael?
Yeah, sure, you can call him.
You're freaking me out. Benji.
Yeah, you answer.
No,
you
don't have to call him.
Who is that?
I'm
who is that?
To a common,
who is that? Friend? Hold on.
Can I tell him who I'm talking to?
Oh, God. Which girl?
I fucking know. I'm talking to Trey.
Jesus fucking Christ. Why are you calling Trey right now? Isn't he on the island?
He's calling me.
Oh, okay. Reggie, listen.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to know something funny?
What?
Shano started talking about what...
down for the idea.
Shano. I didn't say a word.
Fuck this cunt.
He wants to use the whole goddamn place for everything criminal under the sun.
Oh my god. Well, I'll eat my own fucking words on that. Fuck me. Alright, now that you finished bragging, I just had a call from JJ.
What happened now?
He's pissed off at the moment. Yuki, wait here for a sec.
What happened now? Why the fuck is he pissed off?
Alright, so I did the vault with the boys, pissed off because they kept doing bike swaps in it, and they'd already done two, and they went to do a third one, and he said no to a bike. Getting another local bike for a bike swap. Nigel just says on the radio, well, someone other than someone that's friends with cops or best friends with cops, go get a bike.
Well, who said that?
Nigel.
No.
Yeah.
That's a problem.
JJ's super pissed and dealing with that. And I understand, like, we shouldn't just be doing bike after bike after bike. That kind of shit, it is ratty, but that's way out of pocket what he said on the fucking radio, especially coming from fucking Nigel to JJ.
Why the fuck is Nigel talking like that, bro?
Yeah, I don't know. So we need to talk to them and tell them about that shit out.
Where is KJ around? KJ needs to sort this shit out because I'm not gonna be around. Yeah, I'm gonna give him a call.
I'll get KJ. Don't worry about it because I've got it from JJ himself.
Listen. This is not a funny thing, okay? Because let me tell you something, okay? The boys are confident in themselves, but the thing is, sometimes people like me are not around when they are, so they're getting comfy, okay? And now JJ, who's not been around, okay, when they have been, and you know this, I'm not saying JJ's been doing anything wrong. I think JJ's been trying, right? But obviously, they've been doing things a certain way, just like you and Dragon is going to be like Nigel and JJ. Just make them sort it out and tell them that language like that is not going to get anybody nowhere. Okay?
Yeah. What's your thoughts on like using three different box swaps?
I don't give a fuck about the swaps, bro. Listen, the swaps and shit, they don't matter, bro. That's just like, you see what I'm saying? I know why the boys are saying what they're saying. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because
I think what JJ's talking about is that he would like them to at least have a little bit more of a plan than go steal a local bike and get another one out kind of shit.
Yeah. Okay. So this
you know JJ always talks about that stuff?
I know. But this is what you have to remember, all right? JJ, remember when we last talked during his review? He thinks he's Mr. Memorable and does things everything unique. But the last 3-4 times I've done something with him, he's simply taken a Camacho and gone off-road for about 30 minutes, okay? Every single time he had a problem. I'm not even joking. 4 jobs in a row that I've done with him, he resorts to a Camacho and going off-road. So he can't...
Maybe you should have a quick call to...
No, I'm not. I can't. No. This needs to be solved by somebody other than myself so that he understands that it's not just my word. You know what I mean? Because that's what it always comes down to, right? Benji says this, Benji says that. But this is a problem that he needs to hear that involves everybody. Okay, so he thinks
KJ can talk about that.
No. You need to talk about it too because you are the person that JJ would listen to. So this is what you need.
That's the shit thing, though.
No. Listen.
You know that I'm more of the have a plan kind of guy.
No. Listen to me. It's okay to have a plan. What I'm saying is the boys are changing what they're doing. Because the cops have gone batshit crazy. They've gone to the extreme end of going crazy on Seaside whenever we do jobs that we almost feel targeted, correct? And the boys are shifting what they're doing because there's no plan that fucking works without clapping them. So we're doing what the PD want anyway, right? If you use 2 bikes too many times in a row, they can smack you off the bike. They got bike units as well. They ram you to fuck anyway. You get what I'm saying? It's like you have to disconnect yourself from how the cops might feel sometimes, right?
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? It's you like JJ right now, I can tell you right now that he's considering how the cops feel when the cops don't give a fucking shit about us.
Yeah, that's valid.
You know what I mean? Like, that's not like me to be doing the bike 3 times or whatever. You know, you get what I'm saying?
Yeah,
he's taking that shit into consideration. Why the fuck are we thinking that way? And there will be boys on our side who will do the same exact fucking thing and then done. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I think the bigger problem to me is how Nigel was out of pocket on the radio to JJ. KJ and I'll get it handled.
Yeah, I handle it. But the difference is you have to remember JJ is no longer a council member. So they're going to say things the way they want to say. They're going to talk to each other as equals, right?
Yeah, but even as an equal, that's a hell of a...
Nah, I know. That's out of pocket because of the reasons we all understand. So just get that done, okay? Good luck.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh, fuck. Well, apparently there's goddamn fucking drama going around everywhere. So I'm going to go and, you know... You might want to call Reggie, man, because apparently somebody said some crazy shit to JJ, but... Probably be sorted out. Shano! Do you know about what happened with JJ?
Wait, no.
Okay, you didn't do the bank with them. Never mind. Okay.
Yeah. All right, I gotta go again. But all right, easy, brother. I'll later.
Hey, Michael.
Wait, hello. Yeah, what's up?
Did you do the vault with them or no?
Wait. Now, just before.
Yeah.
No, I didn't. No.
Okay. Well, they're just dealing with some drama. I think Reggie and KJ should be able to sort it out. Michael, are you going to be around the same time today? Okay. Like tomorrow?
Like at this hour or earlier?
No, like when were you around? How many hours ago?
How many hours ago? Three hours ago.
Can we finally do the thing with the guards tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. Good night, Michael.
You fucking off?
I'm fucking off. I've been away around way too long. See you tomorrow, Shano. Good night, guys.
See you, mate.
Chat, thank you so much. I appreciate y'all, guys. I didn't want to end the stream with so many things like floating, like talking to Shano and shit like that. I know you guys probably wanted some closure for that too. Thank you so much, everybody. I appreciate all of you. We are going to be raiding Toby. I want you guys to actually spam and make sure that he wakes up earlier, okay, for my sake. Because right now, you know, I can't really wake up any other time. So, you know, when I can in the future, we will. Thank you, guys. All right. I appreciate all of you. Thank you so much. Thank you for the extended stream. You're welcome, Noir. Appreciate you guys. We've been doing good with the goals, yeah. We've been doing with the goals. I feel like we've been teetering around the halfway mark. We're very close. Hopefully, we get a few even bigger W days towards you know, the end of the month. I really appreciate all of you. Thank you for the support. We'll be back again tomorrow, 1 a.m. EST, as we usually are. Tomorrow, chat, we are going to be doing Benji React. We're going to be doing YLYL, and then hopefully some Uncharted variety if we can hit the goals and whatnot. And tonight, maybe I'll be on TikTok. Who knows? Make sure you guys follow us there, okay? Follow me there. Thank you, chat. Love you guys. Bye-bye. Spam when you get to the other stream, okay? I want to see you guys awake. Love you guys. Bye-bye.
Hang out. We've never hung out before.
Have we not?
How cute.
That's like the first time.
Yeah.
Wait, is that supposed to stay?
I haven't even. Nah, whatever. I don't care. That's right. People are just going in and out. It's interesting.